Dear students of class 10A and 10B, here there are some points mentioned in the board: policy of appeasement, rising tide of communism and Bolshevism, and Japanese invasion of China, inactive role of the League, Europe before World War II. First point, policy of appeasement. Now, what is policy of appeasement? The policy of appeasement. Two countries of Europe, France and England, adopted the policy of appeasement for encouraging some countries, those who were humiliated at the end of the First World War, those who were affected, those economy was totally, the countries whose economy was totally destroyed, the country who was humiliated, insulted, in order to encourage them to be self-sufficient, in order to encourage them to strengthen their economic stability by hook or by crook, the policy of appeasement was adopted by these two countries. Now, what was the aim of these two countries, Britain and France? They adopted the policy of appeasement. They adopted the policy of appeasement with a view to let the defeated countries of the First World War to be self-sufficient, to gain back their former image. That means they would occupy a number of territories, they would, in order to strengthen their economy, in order to gain back their former glory and image, and these two countries, England and France, would not interfere in their personal affairs. On the contrary, they would indirectly support them. They would remain neutral, even being warned by the League of Nations. Since both the two countries were the active members of the League of Nations, France and England, in spite of being asked by the League of Nations not to adopt such policy of appeasement, they would not hear it. On the contrary, they would make a stand of neutrality. This policy is known as policy of appeasement, adopted by the two countries of the world, England and France. Now, question is, why did these two countries adopt the policy of appeasement? You know, after the First World War, Germany was forced to sign the Treaty of Versailles, and all the terms of the Treaty of Versailles went against Germany. Germany felt insulted, and under the leadership of Adolf Hitler, Germany was determined to take revenge of it. That's why during the first half of the Second World War, both the two countries remained neutral. When Germany was occupying the colonies of Far East, Asia, Europe and Africa, they remained neutral. Why? Because they adopted the policy of appeasement for allowing Germany to make money to strengthen its economy. That's why they adopted the policy of appeasement. That means this policy of appeasement refers to the policy of reconciliating an aggressive powers at the expense of some, you know, other country. It meant accepting the hostile demands of an aggressive nation to gain peace in order to establish peace. The policy of appeasement was adopted by Germany, by France and England in order to establish peace, in order to allow them to be self-sufficient. They adopted the policy of appeasement. Britain and France followed the policy of appeasement. Why? Because it was their responsibility to establish a peace throughout the world, because two world wars already were taken place. Already two world war already took place. First World War and Second World War was going on. Right that moment, both these two countries decided to adopt such a policy as could give a permanent solution, or as could establish peace throughout the world. Besides, another point that is very important I should discuss, Italy and Germany. Germany and Italy, you know, both of them, they were dictatorial countries. They felt that the dictators had a real cause of grievance due to humiliating treaty of the Treaty of Versailles. And if their grievances were removed, and they would not disturb world peace, both of them decided to allow, Italy and Germany, both of them were dictatorial countries. And they had many grievances because of the Treaty of Versailles, and insulting Treaty of Versailles, and gave them resentment. They felt insulted. That's why the two countries, France and England, decided to remove their grievances. For the Treaty of Versailles, they had been insulting, and they adopted that policy with a view to allow Germany to establish, you know, permanent peace throughout the world, so that the others must not be disturbed by them. Further, they wanted to check the rising tide of communism. You know, next point. Rising tide of communism and Bolshevism. You know, two countries of the world, China and Russia, were trying to establish the influence of political concept of communism and Bolshevism. Communism was the political concept of China. China decided to spread over Asia, Europe and Africa, especially European countries who had been suffering from the Allied powers, in order to gain them strong support, in order to encourage them. China was trying to establish the political concept of communism throughout Italy, Germany, throughout Europe. And another one, Bolshevism. Bolshevism is the political concept of Russia. Russia also was trying to intervene in European politics, and was encouraging to accept the concept of Bolshevism. And it is due to that reason, both the two countries, England and France, they all were scared. Both of them were scared of the influence of communism, influence of Bolshevism. That's why they decided to remove the grievances of Germany by adopting the policy of appeasement. And Britain and France feared that Germany would divert towards Russian Bolshevism. They therefore allowed Germany to rearm and to remilitarize the Rhineland and capture Austria and Czechoslovakia. Since there was a possibility of being influenced by Bolshevism of Russia, the two countries of Europe, Britain and France, decided to allow Germany to invade Czechoslovakia and Austria, and at the same time they also encouraged them, that means they encouraged Germany to remilitarize the Rhineland, to allow them, they also encouraged them to rearm and remilitarize the Rhineland in order to satisfy Germany indirectly. They therefore allowed Germany to rearm and remilitarize. So, without the Western countries' policy of appeasement, fascism or Nazism could not have survived so long and would not have been able to unleash the Second World War. Both the two countries, Britain and France, felt that the policy of appeasement would refrain Germany from entering alliances with other countries, other powerful countries. In that case, Germany would be more and more powerful. In order to prevent Germany from entering into any alliance, they adopted the policy of appeasement. In order to make Germany diverted from the aim of establishing Bolshevism or communism in Germany. These two powers of Europe, Britain and France, adopted the policy of appeasement in order to satisfy the needs and expectations of Germany. In order to allow Germany to be self-sufficient, to strengthen its economy, to demilitarize, to rearm for the Rhineland, which was the first and foremost duty of Germany, to rearm and demilitarize, these two countries allowed Germany to do so. That's why Germany also did not enter into any alliance with other powers. Second, next point, Japanese invasion of China. Japanese policy of expansion was another cause of war. Japan's ambition rose after the First World War. Why? She was determined to dominate the Far East. In 1931, Japan intervened in Manchuria and, in spite of League's opposition, occupied it and set up a government there. Japan also started an undeclared war against China in 1931. China appealed to the League of Nations to declare sanctions against Japan. Britain and France, the leading members of the League, did not pay any attention to the appeal. Japan joined the Berlin-Rome Axis to form the Berlin-Rome-Tokyo Axis to further its policy of expansion and conquest. In 1933, Japan left the League of Nations and started occupying the British and American properties in China. Britain and France followed the policy of appeasement, thinking that the Japanese could be used to weaken China. Thus, a war was inevitable under these circumstances. That means the policy of appeasement had some drawbacks, had some defects. There are certain defects behind it. Number one, from Asian country, Japan wanted to be powerful. When Britain and France was adopting the policy of appeasement, Japan decided to establish many colonies towards the Far East. because a very less number of colonies were there and in the hands of Japan. Due to the growth and development of industrial revolution, it was very important to the Asian countries to establish colonies in different parts of the world so that they must meet the growing demands of their factories and industries. They must supply raw materials from those colonies which were weak. Japan adopted the same policy of America, same policy of Russia, and same policy of Germany and France. And hence, in the year 1931, Japan attacked Manchuria. After that attack, Chinese government lodged complaint against Japan to the League of Nations. League of Nations drew the attention of two countries, Britain and France. But already, as I mentioned, Britain and France adopted the policy of appeasement. That's why they did not pay any attention towards the crisis and towards the problems arised by Japan. So League of Nations failed to convince, failed to make it understand to the two countries, Britain and France. And so Japan's aspiration also were increased. Japan now decided to occupy the territories, the properties of Britain and America, what they had left in China. So the properties of America, the properties of Britain, which were left in China, now Japan decided to occupy it. Japan decided to occupy the properties of Britain and America in China. And Britain and France thought that Japan was doing it so in order to weaken China. And both the two countries, France and Britain, was trying, both of the two countries were trying to remove the concept of communism from Europe. But it was China who was deliberately trying to establish the political concept of communism throughout Europe. As soon as Japan started occupying the properties of America and Britain in China, both the two countries, America and Britain, thought that would be better for them, since Japan was occupying the territories of China in order to weaken China. And whenever China would be weakened, China would not have any opportunity to spread their political concept of communism throughout Europe. So they wanted to support the policy of Japan. Although their properties were occupied by Japan, yet these two countries, America and Britain, temporarily remained silent. But Japan in the meantime signed a treaty with Germany. Germany named Berlin Tokyo Axis. So this treaty, Berlin Rome Tokyo Axis, in this treaty, three countries of Europe, Germany, Italy, and from Asian country, Japan, they signed the Berlin, Rome, and Tokyo Axis, and challenge the authority of the Allied powers. Under such circumstances, it was inevitable to start or to declare war against this Axis power, Italy, Germany, and Japan. Next point, my dear students. Next point, Europe before World War II. Europe was facing a lot of problem because of the defeated powers. Italy and Germany were insulted by the Treaty of Versailles, as I told you earlier, at the end of the First World War. And as soon as the First World War was ended, both the two countries of Europe, Italy and Germany, gave a birth of two political concepts, as I mentioned earlier, the concept of fascism in Italy and the concept of Nazism in Germany. Fascism was formed under the leadership of Mussolini in Italy, and Nazism was formed under the leadership of Hitler in Germany. Both of the two leaders were gradually becoming powerful and wanted and trying to re-establish the former glory and image of the two countries, Italy and Germany, respectively. That's why both the two countries were creating troubles for Allied powers. And Allied powers at the 11th hour, on behalf of Allied powers, two countries, as I mentioned earlier, Britain and France, adopted the policy of appeasement in order to remove all grievances of these two countries, Italy and Germany, who were severely affected by the Treaty of Versailles, who were severely insulted by the terms of the Treaty of Versailles. That's why they were trying to take revenge against the Allied powers in order to make them stop these two countries, Britain and France, adopted the policy of appeasement. And afterwards, the war became inevitable to the Allied powers because of the growing influence of Japan. Suddenly, Japan was becoming very much powerful by taking the advantage of adopting the policy of appeasement of Britain and France. Up to this, my dear students. Thank you.